Okay, welcome back. Our question, should Chief Justice Renato Corona testify in his own trial? And we will ask our guests here.
Definitely.
Atty. Avila, should he and why?
I think he should, and definitely he should. He called attention to his own testimony when he made the media blitz last week. And before the impeachment process, he promised that he will defend himself and respect the proceedings before the Senate. Now, towards the middle, he started modifying his statement, if you notice.
Yeah.
Hindi na ako mag, hindi niya sinasabing mag-aapir na ako. Mag-aapir ako
defense
kung alone. Pumayag yung aking defense panel. But last week, he was again on the loose in media, and he modified it again and said he will testify as to his dollar account and as to other matters that were raised by the prosecution.
So what could be the difficulty should he be there?
Well, the difficulty would be the extent to which he would be asked questions and the degree of respect that would be accorded to him as the Chief Justice.
The degree of respect, that's important.
And I think that's very important. You still have to respect the institution, no matter where you are in this process, whether you're in the defense or in the prosecution, whether you hate his guts or whatever, you still have to respect the fact that he is the Chief Justice of the Philippines and ask proper questions. Ask them politely, but ask hard questions. That doesn't prevent you from asking hard questions, provided they're asked properly and with respect for the position.
Okay.
I think the good Senate President, Senator Enrile, was quoted this morning in the papers that he would not allow any senator to disrespect the Chief Justice. And he will make sure that the questions, while maybe tough, no, will be respectful of the Chief Justice in deference to the institution that he represents. No? But I agree with Rudy that that the Chief Justice should testify, and I think he will testify, because no one else can explain better than the Chief Justice with respect to his position. No?
You're going back to what you're telling me now, that Senator Enrile said that he will not allow disrespectful manner of anyone, maybe even the present team of the defense, and you know, referring to the experience of the prosecution team members. Is there a way that they can actually handle Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago? Is there an ethics committee among...
Well, the Senate President said that he will not hesitate citing any senator for contempt if he shows disrespect for the Chief Justice. And in fact, he said he does not mind being removed. He will be very adamant in his position that he will not allow disrespectful question of the Chief Justice. No.
Okay, what is a disrespectful question? How can that be phrased?
Well,
if the intention is to embarrass or to humiliate?
Actually, Tina, there is a rule that the witness should not be insulted. He should not be asked any question that will require an answer that will degrade him. So if these questions are asked on a witness, whether he is the accused or whatever, the presiding officer has the duty to call the attention of the whoever propounded that question. That it should not be allowed, because a witness is supposed to help the court in resolving the issue before the court, and not to be insulted while he was on the witness stand.
Okay, in the course, if you were in the senator judge in the course of your asking your own questions, what might be a question that could be disrespectful in relation to the dollar account?
By the way, Tina, if this is a criminal case, no one can compel the Chief Justice to take the witness stand if he does not lie.
But
meaning that the right of the accused in a criminal case is different. I cannot classify this as a criminal case.
Even if it's akin to a criminal case?
Yes, but to me, actually, the public prosecutor can call the Chief Justice to the witness stand if it is not a criminal case. But if it is a criminal case, no one can compel him to take the witness's stand.
So you're saying that the prosecution can actually call the Chief Justice?
Yes, if we classify it not as a criminal case. But if it is a criminal case, we cannot call him to the witness's stand.
So is there a way, or there should be a declaration by this court, the Senate court, to declare what kind of a case this is? Do you want that settled?
There should be a declaration now, because it will deprive the public prosecutor of the right to call a witness to the witness's stand if it is not a criminal case. Mm-hmm. There is such thing as calling an adverse party, meaning you don't have to respect the art of asking question on direct examination, meaning you are not allowed to ask leading questions. But here, if he is called as an adverse party, you can lead him already to admit certain facts of the case.
Okay, what will move the defense or even the prosecution, who you say the prosecution can actually call him to the stand? What should they do to be able
to call the Chief Justice?
To call the Chief Justice and to ask the Senate, the court, to declare this as a criminal case? Can they do that?
I think
because they've always said in many occasions that this is not a criminal case, this is a political case, is that going to be jailed, etc., etc.
I think in one session, Tina, there was a consensus that certain rights of the accused must still be respected, the right to be presumed innocent until proven otherwise, the right against self-incrimination. Mm-hmm. So I think there was already a previous ruling in that respect. So the Chief Justice cannot be compelled to testify because he's entitled to invoke his right against self-incrimination. But if he wants to,
there is a ruling already by the Senate court.
At one of the sessions, there was an agreement that certain rights must be respected. While it's not a criminal proceeding, certain rights of the accused must be respected, like the right to be presumed innocent, the right to invoke his right against self-incrimination, and similar rights under the Constitution.
Okay, the right to invoke against self-incrimination means if I don't like to appear, I will not appear, even if called.
Yes.
But if it were a criminal...
That's why you did not subpoena the Chief Justice.
Mm-hmm. Ah, okay.
I don't know if this is allowed under the Senate rules, but if you remember during the Clinton impeachment, Bill Clinton appeared in his own impeachment. He was deposed by deposition, I think.
Yeah, he was in a special...
It was a televised deposition.
Yes, yes.
So that solves certain problems of propriety and respect for the position of the highest person in the executive
branch. That could
branch.
Be a model of how it can be done without the Chief Justice actually appearing before all the senator judges in a court.
Yes.
But he will be in a special room where all of the questions can be written down, and just the special prosecutor who represents the Congress.
But let's remember that the Senate rules of impeachment in the Clinton trial are very different from the ones that are exercised here. Mm-hmm. There they had preliminary proceedings, and a lot of evidence was admitted and discussed even before the actual Senate trial. Mm-hmm. Remember, Kenneth Starr investigated this entire thing. That's why napakapulido ng pagka-draft ng impeachment complaint, because before they even drafted the impeachment complaint, Starr had about half a year to investigate. Mm-hmm. So it was really, well laid down. No?
Mm-hmm.
Now, in the U.S. impeachment case, the senators were not allowed to ask questions. Mm-hmm. They could submit written questions, mm-hmm. but not the way it is asked here. I think if they want to preserve some semblance of propriety in this case, they should adopt that, at least for the testimony of the Chief Justice. Mm-hmm.
Can they still do it, Justice Palatao? Adopt the model that was used by the U.S. Congress in relation to Bill Clinton's impeachment?
That cannot be done anymore.
Because the rules are already...
Yes.
But they cannot modify in transit?
It cannot, because it's going to affect the substantial rights of the accused. By the way, Tina,
one last point.
If the Chief Justice will voluntarily take the witness's stand, then he cannot invoke his right against self-incrimination. He has to answer questions that has something to do with the impeachment charges against him.
Any and all that could be
any
raised?
Any and all, except, of course, those that they already abandoned.
Okay. Points well taken. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Rudyard, for joining me again. It's good to see you.
Yes.
Good to see you, and Dean Nilo and Justice
Pleasure.
Palatao. Maraming salamat. That's all the time we have. Talk to us again next week on Talkback.